I heard the rumor Apache ECharts are highly customizable and intuitive. They also say this open source project is said to be Apache's foundation top-level project. That sounds encouraging. However, I would be curious to know whether Apache ECharts are resourceful enough when it comes to solving real-world problems. In this video, I will share how we employed a graph chart from the Apache ECharts library to visualize a summary of the company's accomplishments. And you can decide for yourself. Let's go! Hello and welcome to this channel. I am Daria Volkova, a data analyst with a deep love for data visualizations. My brain naturally translates any data value into some sort of dynamic image. The other day, when my company was discussing the best way to present our 6-month accomplishments, I envisioned a dynamic graphical illustration. To my joy, I found a way to make my idea real, to create the graphical representation that I had in mind. Let's take a quick look. Here is the graph displayed in the Grafana dashboard on the Apache ECharts panel. All the basics about Grafana and ECharts you can find in my previous video, this one. Okay, so here in the middle, you see the Balena application plugin, which is one of our products. Every product we manage leaves its footprints on the YouTube channel, Medium, a platform hosting our blog, GitHub, and in most cases, some other venues. As depicted in this visualization, for the Balena application plugin, we have one video, one article, one major release, and one minor release. Furthermore, in the group of all other venues, we have an article posted on the Balena blog and the Balena app project hosted on hub.balena.io. Let's take a look at another product, Apache ECharts panel. The product we launched recently. For this one, we created one video. It is depicted right here. The other activities include an article on Medium and one release on GitHub. Nothing on other venues as of today. Using filters on top of the page, I can review any product we manage in support and swiftly get an idea of what is happening with it. Another analysis that can smoothly be propagated is the view from a venue perspective. For example, here is what everything published on our YouTube channel looks like. I grouped all videos by the relevant product. That brings me to having 9 groups where I can examine how many videos we produced for every product. After looking at this, I realized we spent too much time on the Grafana general category. We should focus more effort on our products. Here is how the view from Medium, the blog publishing venue, turned out. One article involves 5 products. And it seems too many articles have been published about Grafana in general. I will only scratch the surface if I point out that Apache ECharts allowed me to load custom images for graph nodes, adjust colors and sizes, set the style for edges, use my company logo on the background, and work with many other configurations. I aim to explain everything step by step to ensure many more people can get creative and let their imaginations run wild, knowing that everything dreamed of can land on the analytics dashboard. Data visualization can and should be done in style. As always, for your convenience, timestamps are available in the description box below. Please use them to jump to the chapter of interest. Use case description and requirements. I start with a detailed use case description. Before diving into any configuration, I would like to ensure it is clear what was the initial goal. Graphs are one of the most complex data structures to visualize. Once they are constructed, they sure look nice, giving you that long-sought power to convey the message swiftly. However, before you can specify all nodes and edges, you need to get intimate with the domain knowledge and get as much input as possible about what type of data will be displayed and what kind of relationships exist. In my case, we needed to depict information about our 9 products, the GitHub releases, YouTube videos, blog articles, collaborations with other companies, and all other events like being published on an online magazine or participating in a conference. That brought me to having entities like activities, where an activity is anything we do, things such as developing plugins, publishing a video, etc. I wanted to see those activities grouped by products, meaning I would need a list of all activities related to a specific product. In addition, I needed another grouping, which is by venue. So here we would have a list of activities performed on YouTube, GitHub, Medium, and alike. On a wish list, I got the visualization should be engaging and, if possible, drawn in the company style. And last but certainly not least, the work should be completed in 2 days. That means my design should be implementable in less than 16 hours. Now let's talk about data structure. I am planning to store my data in an SQL database. Therefore, my data structure needs to be designed in a table format. Let's see how a graph feeds into tables. A regular graph is a structure that consists of nodes and edges, or links. Edges are connections. In the case of regular graph, the data structure consists of two data arrays, the array of nodes, where every node has a unique identifier, and the array of edges. An edge is uniquely identified as a combination of a source node and a target node. Obviously, both source and target must come from the first array. And again, in a regular graph, all nodes are very much alike. They are the same entities. So for the simple graph, I need two tables, one with nodes and the other one with edges. Let me open the echarts.apache.org website to see how that can be implemented using the Apache ECharts. Click Demo, find the graph category, open this example where they built a random graph. While I change the code on the left-hand side, I instantly see the results on the right-hand side. The code on the left side is written in JavaScript. The good news is that to utilize Apache ECharts, you don't have to be an expert in JavaScript. But some bare minimum of JavaScript will indeed help. Before working here, let me briefly explain what part of JavaScript you need to comprehend.
Please skip to the next section if you don't need any introduction to JavaScript data structures.
Any example on the demo section has those three tabs: edit code, full code, and option preview. If I open the full code tab of any example and scroll down, I will find this call, the call of setOption function. And the only parameter that is passed down there is option. This option is the key to understanding how ECharts is configured. So, option is a JavaScript data structure. It is an object. In JavaScript, an object is a collection of key-value pairs. This data structure is also called map, dictionary, or hash table in other programming languages. The simple object can be described like this, where Daria underscore object is the object name. When in curly brackets, I have three key value pairs. That structure gives JavaScript enormous power because a value could be array, one-dimensional or multi-dimensional. Another key value pair, sometimes called nested structure, and obviously simple text or number. By the way, the array is taken into square brackets, like this. Let's get back to the first example on echarts.apache.org. Here I can see one object with the name option. It has three key value pairs inside. Series consists of type and data. Type is a simple text value equal to line, and the data is a one-dimensional array of integer values. Y-axis consists of one key value pair where a key is type and a value is the text value. X-axis consists of two key value pairs, type and data. Type is one key value pair and data is an array of integer values. In this example, they show one possible scenario of how the object option can be populated in order to build a line graph. Once the data structure is populated, it gets passed into the function called setOption, which is the primary ECharts function. That function builds graphs after processing all the values that are coming from the option parameter. Now, how would you know all existing attributes or properties that are in the ECharts arsenal? The catalog of all parameters is in the resource cheat sheet menu. It looks like a listing of all parameters on the left side with descriptions on the right. That listing might be overwhelming at first. Reading it is not the best way to kick off your learning curve, especially if you are new to JavaScript or data visualization. A more manageable and speedier approach is to start by spotting the graph that resembles the most what you envision for your project and build the configuration from there. Just for fun, let's change the symbol on the line to triangle. For that, I specify the symbol key with the value triangle. I cannot see any change. Let me set up the symbol size to 60. Okay, here are my triangles. Then what about diamond? And now, what about SVG XML format? I insert the text here into the same symbol parameter and enjoy something unique. I will speak more about using several image formats later in this video. I will mention Base64, SVG as a path, and SVG in XML format. ECharts graph data structure. All right, now we can get back to examining the graph chart setup. The code on the left-hand side looks a little too packed, and it has many more instructions that I need to prove my concept. I will simplify the code by keeping as few rows of code as possible. First, I remove the setInterval function. It is a JavaScript function that is getting called every 200 milliseconds. That's why the graph on the right is constantly changing. I do not want that. Then I remove the force parameter and animation. Clean the data attributes. Perfect. Now I have that bare minimum enough to build a simple graph. Layout force here means the nodes will be placed on the canvas by algorithm find the best location possible. The other option is circle, where nodes are placed in a circle, like in this example. And also you can specify none. In the case of none, every node will have to have X and Y coordinates, meaning I will have to set an exact canvas location for every single node. I'm not after circle, nor do I want to worry about the precise location. I'm happy with what the layout force is doing. Namely, I want to let the algorithm decide where to place my nodes on the canvas. All right, the code is clean and I'm ready to create my node and edges. I will start with four nodes, uniquely identifying them using integer numbers from 1 to 4, one node per a curly bracket. 1, 2, 3, 4. Click this Run button. The graph on the right-hand side has been updated, and I see four nodes. Now let's specify edges. One edge goes into a curly bracket. The bare minimum for an edge is two things, source and target. Let's create the edge from node 1 to node 2. And here is when I realize I need a way to distinguish nodes. Otherwise, I cannot verify the connections are created according to my data. Let's add some colors. In Apache ECharts, every node has the item style parameter, and inside I can specify a few things. At this time, I only need color. I would use RGB notation for simplicity. RGB stands for red, green, blue, and looks like three integer numbers from 0 to 255, representing how much red, green, blue color you want to add into the mix. Let's make the first node red, the second green, the third node blue, and the last node black. Finally, I can get back to the node specification. I want the red node to be in the middle and all others have connections with it. Perfect. The proof of concept is working, which means I have confirmed that for a regular graph, I need two tables, one to capture nodes and the other to specify edges.